Hello guys, Shokugeki here, and today I'll be reviewing Food Wars Shokugeki no Soma Season 3. This season was split into two parts, which means the first half of the season aired, and then the anime took a very short break, and the second half of the season resumed. In this season, Soma begins to challenge members within the Itosuki Elite 10 Council, which are the best students within Itosuki Academy. It was nice seeing Soma meet another rival in Tsukasa, who is number one student within the Elite 10 Council. I liked how Tsukasa and Soma really respect each other, and want to beat each other during a Shokugeki. I'll be very interested to see how Soma will be able to defeat Tsukasa in the future, as Tsukasa appears to excel at making any dishes. I really liked it when Soma challenged Kuga, who was another member of the Elite 10 Council. They compete against each other in terms of Chinese dishes, and those dishes look so good. I'm a big fan of Chinese dishes, and the Mapo Tofu was my favorite dish this season. It just looks so good and spicy. Considering Kuga's specialty is in spicy Chinese dishes, it was intriguing seeing Soma try to create a better spicy Chinese dish than him. He really did his research into Chinese dishes, and with the help of his friends, he was able to compete with Kuga. I love the strategy he came up with to steal Kuga's customers away from him. It was ingenious. This season was most memorable to me because of Azumi, who acted like a true villain. Azumi is Eren's father, and someone who was kicked out of the academy because of his strict teaching methods. Up until now, Soma did compete against strong and sometimes arrogant opponents, but they really weren't twisted and evil. Azumi wanted to kick out all students who didn't follow his philosophy in terms of making gourmet dishes. He wanted to shut down all clubs at school, and he planned to shut down all restaurants within the area that didn't serve gourmet food. He was truly crazy and didn't care about other people's feelings. He was acting like a dictator. Either you're with him or you're against him, and it'll make your life a living nightmare if you're against him. He perfectly fit the role of a villain, and indirectly helped Soma and his friends grow as chefs. He made the show that much better as he pushed Soma and his friends to the limit. They had to find creative ways to pass tests, even when it was rigged against them. Soma found creative ways to make up for a lack of ingredients during a test. I love seeing the shock look on the instructors' faces when they realized their evil plan failed. It wasn't just Soma doing it all on his own. There was a lot of teamwork involved, as his friends gave him tips and inspired him at times in terms of making new dishes. In Season 3, Erina had the most character development. She is usually really cold towards anyone who is not Hisako, but in this season, she made a lot of friends within the Polar Star Dormitory. When Erina needs someone to save her from her father, Soma and his friends gave her a place to stay. They showed her kindness and also showed her how much fun cooking can be. Erina finally relaxed and stopped judging people harshly for their level of cooking. She in fact gave him tips in order to help them improve their cooking skills. Many people may have hated her character early on in the series, but Erina has now turned into such a likable character that is a little bit shy and will do anything to protect her friends. She is no longer the cold character she used to be. I'm glad the anime gave her character development because it would have gotten annoying if she continued to act cold throughout the show. This season also gave us some romantic development between Erina and Soma, which I liked. You could tell Erina is slowly falling in love with Soma. She is blushing more and more around him. She is really thankful for him helping her get away from her dad. I'm glad we got to see some romantic development between them, because later on in future seasons, it won't come as a surprise if she ends up dating him. Erina also grew as a person in another way, in that she wasn't afraid to be her own person. In the past, she would just follow whatever her dad told her to do because she feared him. With Soma and his friend's support, she was finally able to break free of her dad's control. It was great seeing her go against her dad and making her own decisions in life. She showed so much courage as a person. One of my favorite moments in this show was Erina finally figuring out that Soma is the son of the man she admired so much. To see her shocked face upon realizing it was so entertaining. It makes you wonder, how will she treat Soma now? Will she respect him more? In terms of the Shokugeki battles this season, there was another objective that Soma was trying to achieve this season. Soma was not only trying to make the best dish during Shokugeki, but show that he can win by making creative dishes that don't follow a strict procedure. He wanted to show the Elite 10 and Azumi that you don't have to cook in a true gourmet method to succeed in making wonderful dishes. Dishes don't have to be gourmet food in order to be considered great. I like the message that the show was trying to send. I feel like I can relate to it well. There are some small restaurants that I eat at that I consider much more delicious than certain expensive restaurants out there. It isn't all about making the dishes look fancy. There were several dishes this season that looked so delicious, and I was surprised that they looked so good. I was not expecting bear meat to look so tasty in anime form, but this anime even made bear meat look so delicious. I really liked how the anime went into detail on how to make bear meat not smell so bad, and how to cook it so that it tastes wonderful. The Team Shokugeki at the end of the season was fascinating to watch, as we haven't seen a Team Shokugeki before. It was interesting seeing all the characters working together to make a certain dish. In terms of the new characters this season, the two characters that I liked the best were Tsukasa and Rindo. Tsukasa looked like a cold person, obsessed with cooking, but surprisingly, he had a very funny side to him whenever he got nervous a lot or stressed out a lot. I liked that the anime didn't just show him as an arrogant character. Rindo was a very funny character, as she was so relaxed about everything and got so excited when trying out dishes. Not to mention she was really hot. The openings for the season were good. The songs were nice to listen to. The endings were nice to watch as well. The songs during the episodes were good. It really made the Shokugekis feel more intense. The animation style for the season looked the same as previous two seasons, which was good. The animation was good for the most part. Characters move around naturally. I didn't notice any major animation errors. I do recommend watching the season if you already watched the previous two seasons. This season actually had a true villain that is making everything have high stakes. If Soma doesn't fight back against Azumi, his dormitory could be gone, the clubs could be shut down, and all restaurants that aren't serving food in a true gourmet way will be shut down. Azumi is trying to force everyone to cook in the way he wants them to cook, and if they don't follow his way, then they will never be allowed to cook again. The high stakes in this anime made everything so suspenseful and made me so interested in the episodes. It made that much more enjoyable seeing Soma try to figure out ways to pass a test or win a Shokugeki that were rigged against him and his friends. The other major reason why I like the season, and why you should watch it as well, is that Erina finally becomes a likable character to watch. No longer is she looking down on people in annoying ways. I give the season a 9 out of 10. So that's all I wanted to talk about for today. Thank you for watching this video. Have a great day or night wherever you are, and please like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video, and please comment if you found anything interesting in the video.